One other thing, and I know that you wrote about this, reported on this. I'll go back to Kyler Murray and the role that his dad could play in all of this. Is he one of those helicopter parents hovering here, and could that be an issue?
Well, Dan, you had Kyler on your show. I believe at one point you were asking Dad to chime in for a comment within that interview. And I can tell you, credit to the show, a lot of NFL people were watching that too. A lot of NFL people were watching all the interviews that Kyler Murray did during Super Bowl week. They were awkward, to say the least.
Were they bothered by it, Tom?
They certainly got the sense that this was not a kid who is in control of his career. And that is not just simply from those interviews. It's also from digging into what happened when he transferred from Texas A&M, digging into the way that, you know, baseball has kind of been an influence here, and the fact that, you know, early December, Scott Boras is proclaiming publicly that Kyler Murray is completely committed to the A's. Meanwhile, 2 months before that, scouts have been getting asked by people at Oklahoma saying, hey, Kyler's dad's been calling about about potential draft projections for the NFL. What do you think of the guy? It's not something that is, you know, something that's going to rule out Kyler Murray or a huge knock on the kid, who by all accounts is a very nice kid. He's more introverted, quiet, laid back than a lot of quarterbacks, but teams are absolutely going to want to spend time with Kevin Murray. They're not entirely comfortable just with baseball being in the back pocket. If, you know, if Kyler goes to a team he doesn't want to, or if he's not starting right away, could baseball potentially be an influence? I reached out to Kevin Murray before I wrote about this and talked about it. You know, he says that we're advising Kyler, but he's the one making his decisions. He's all in on football. It's, you know, something that teams that are potentially drafting Kyler Murray are just going to want to examine thoroughly, you know, because you've got to ultimately develop the confidence that we're not going to be wasting a pick here.
You know, we were discussing that. Remember, we all went out that night and had a bite to eat. We were discussing, will teams be bothered at all by the interview on our show, or the lack of interview, or is that overthinking? Because we take note, you know, as you said before, we take no pride in how that went off. We didn't. That was definitely not our goal. No. It's to trip somebody up or get them in an awkward spot. But I wonder if teams look at that interview and say, little deal, big deal, no big deal.
I think it's a little deal that could be a bigger deal, because that's how I viewed it. Once we were done, we went out to dinner that night, and I thought, you know what? If I'm a GM or a coach, like, it's just awkward that you're doing that. You're out there and you're getting paid to promote something, and, you know, you can't handle these questions. And these are basic questions. It's not like I did a gotcha with Kyler Murray. And that would bother me. And I thought about that when we were done. And I really wanted to pull him to the side when we were done to say, hey, you really, if you're going to do this and do this for a living and you want to make money like this, then you have to be smarter about your approach here, because that doesn't help you. You're not selling your product and you're not selling you. But you don't have to say anything. Derek Jeter made an entire career out of not saying anything, but giving you the impression that he was saying something, or he certainly is nice, but he wasn't saying anything. You know, you have to be ready for those questions, and you have to be ready to answer something. But yeah, I looked at that and I thought it was certainly a little deal. And that's why my point is, if I'm at the combine, I don't care how tall you are, how fast you are, how big your hands are, I want to talk to you. That's the most important thing that I would want out of sitting down with Kyler Murray. If you said, hey, you want to watch him throw? No, I'm good. Do you want, you know, these people who said, boy, there was an NFL scout. Oh, you know, there's no velocity there. I can tell you firsthand, when he threw a 20-yard pass to McLovin, it's as hard as any quarterback threw a ball that week or even the previous Super Bowl, except for Aaron Rodgers. And I'm talking about zip. Zip. But I want to sit down with him. I want to know who he is. Is he hungry? Is he got a chip on his shoulder? Drew Brees still has a chip on his shoulder. He's a Hall of Famer. He'll have the most statistics. He'll lead in the most statistics of any quarterback when he's done. First ballot Hall of Famer. He still has a chip on his shoulder because of what people said about him going into the draft. There's nothing left to prove, but it feels like he has everything left to prove. Is Kyler Murray going to be that kind of player, that kind of athlete? Tom Brady still has a chip on his shoulder, because all those teams passed on him.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.